Well, first of all, I'm glad to be back in France. It's been 2 years. I really missed it. I turned 43 recently, and for a Russian, 43 is like 78 in Western European years. I don't have much time left, so I figured I got to write a memoir, you know, before it's all over. And in America, we love memoirs because we're all about reality, you know, reality TV and stuff like that. So I don't have much of an imagination, so the last three novels, were really autobiographical as well. So I was born in the Soviet Union in 1972. And then in 79, America and the Soviet Union reached a deal where Russia had trouble with, there was no grain, there were bad harvests. So Russia desperately needed American grain. And America desperately needed more Jews. You always need a lot of Jews. So millions of tons of grain were sent from America for 50,000 Jews. So I was basically traded for a baguette or a croissant, you know. Can you imagine? I don't know who got the better deal there, but that's how it happened. So all of a sudden I ended up in America, but being a Russian in America in 79, and it was so bad, I was sentenced to 8 years of Hebrew school for a crime I did not commit, but I had to go there for 8 years. It was so bad, I had to tell the kids that I was born not in Leningrad, but in East Berlin. You know things are bad when you have to pretend to Jewish kids that you're actually a German, but that's what it was. And also I had this giant fur hat made out of some woodland animal and giant fur coat, and the teachers would take me aside and say, you know, you have to get rid of all your fur. Kids will play with you more if you're furless, which is true in adulthood as well, I've learned. Very true. But it was very tough, and we were poor, you know, we didn't have anything, and it was a terrible life. But then things got better, sort of. They're still not that great.